Danny. 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 Danny, I've been looking all over for you. I just met Billy and Henry. They told me they'd left you here. Did you forget this was my wedding day?
Uh-oh.
Well, then why aren't you at home? The house is full of guests. We've been waiting for you.
You didn't have to. You can get married without me.
Danny, I'm surprised at you.
It's not so important for me to be there.
It's important to me, son. It's important to Anne, too. Everything will be the same as before, only better. You know, Danny, it was pretty lonesome at times, just the two of us.
I wasn't lonesome.
I was, son. Well, you've always been my best pal, and I think I've always been yours. And as my pal, you've got to try to understand about Anne and me. That's what makes people pals, son. Understanding each other. As a matter of fact, you need Anne as much as I do. Even more. It's easier for a man to get along without a wife than it is a small boy to get along without a mother.
I've been getting along okay.
Is that all you have to say to me? Look, won't you even give Anne a chance?
Well, okay. I'll give her a chance.
Now you're talking. Holy smoke. I'm going to be late for my own wedding. Come on.
See? You're scared already. We got one. We got one. Boy, oh boy.
Play him, son. Play him. That's it.
Boy, oh boy. And Henry and Billy bet me a knife and whistle I wouldn't catch one. Wait till I tell them.
Come on, son. I left the car back here by the road.
Come on, Skipper.
That's a nice thing.
It's the bridegroom who seems to have forgotten.
Doris, you know better.
He's a half hour late already.
Well, he went to look for Danny.
They'll be here any minute, I'm sure.
I don't know what's gotten into Danny. We used to be very close. When Laura was alive, he used to run to me every time she'd scold him. I thought he'd be happy about having me for his mother.
He will. He's probably jealous because he'll have to share his father with you. I suppose Hugh has been spoiling him.
I'd say he's a darn lucky kid to be getting you for a mother.
Now, don't you worry, sweet. While I'm here these few days, I'll have a talk with him, and then...
Here they are now. Danny's still in his play clothes.
Well, I'll see that he gets cleaned up in a jiffy.
By the authority vested in me, I now pronounce you man and wife. Kiss the bride. Congratulations, sir.
Oh, Anne, darling. Congratulations. Hello, Sally. How are you?
We're going to be very happy, Danny, the three of us. Aren't you going to kiss me? We'll have fun. Wait and see.
Thank you.
Thank you
very much.
Thank you.
Goodbye, folks. Thanks for coming.
Thank you, Bill.
Don't forget what I told you, Danny.
Be a good boy, son, and listen to Louise until we return. We'll be back in a few days. Goodbye, Sonny.
Bye.
Goodbye,
Bill.
Goodbye,
Bill. Good luck. Bye.
Skipper, go back?
Uh-huh. I saw him stop before we turned the last bend.
He usually rides in the car with us. I guess he thought we'd forgotten him. You happy, Mrs. Mitchell?
Very, Mr. Mitchell.
I thought he'd get over it in a few days, but he's still all broken up.
Well, why didn't you wire us, Louise?
Oh, Hugh, I didn't want to spoil your honeymoon. After all, it was just a little old pup.
To a child like Danny, a little old pup is the most important thing in the world. Hugh, maybe if you talk to him.
Yes, I will.
Oh, I've talked and talked to him, but it's like pouring water on a duck's back. Maybe if you got him another dog.
Yes. Children forget.
Anyway, I'm so sorry you had to come back and find him like this. I tried everything to get him over it.
Oh, I'm sure you did. And we can't thank you enough for everything.
Oh, that goes for me too, Louise. I don't know what we would have done if you hadn't taken over. Stayed home, I guess.
Oh, forget it. You do the same for me.
Well, I'll be seeing him.
Yes. Now, don't you worry, sweet. Everything's going to be all right. Time heals all wounds.
Bye now. Bye.
Hey, Danny! You coming? The fish are jumping.
Yeah, Danny. The fish are jumping.
No, not today. I got some important work to do.
Maybe you can come tomorrow.
Yeah, maybe tomorrow.
Yeah, maybe tomorrow.
Come on, Shorty. Come on.
How about some fishing, son? They bite best this time of the day, you know.
Oh, boy, that'll be swell. I'll go get my fishing pole. I bet you we catch the biggest fish you ever saw.
We're off.
Oh, there you are, Hugh. I'm ready.
Ready? Oh, yes. Son, I'm sorry. I promised to drive Ann downtown to do some shopping.
Want to go along, Daddy?
No.
I'm sorry, son. We'll make it again sometime. Like me to bring you something from downtown? Sure you won't go along?
Uh-uh.
Okay.
Bye, Danny.
Before, only better. Yeah. We'll have fun together, the three of us. Yes, we will. We'll make it some other time. Yeah, 20 years from now.
Danny, dinner will be ready in a minute, honey. You better come in and wash.
My goodness, honey, what happened to your face? Better go up and wash it right away.
I like it this way.
Well, I don't.
Folks who don't like it don't have to stay around and look at it.
Just the same, you go up and wash it. Did you hear me, Danny?
You must have misunderstood her, son.
She doesn't like my face. That's exactly what she said.
You're imagining things.
How about my pipe and tobacco, kiddo?
Sure, I'll go get it.
Here it is, darling.
A match, son?
Sure, I'll get some.
Never mind, Danny.
Thank you, darling.
Bite you?
Didn't touch me.
You better keep your distance from that animal, kid. He's bad medicine.
What kind of dog is he?
German.
Police dog?
No, I mean he comes from Germany. He was in the German army.
Gosh, how did you get him?
Well, I was fighting over there then myself. And that's too long a story to go into right now.
What's his name?
His real name's a mouthful. I call him Rusty for short.
Are you gonna keep him?
I don't know. He's vicious and hard to handle. I never saw a dog like him. You just can't teach him. Shut up! Comes to hair! Comes to hair!
Comes to hair? What kind of talk was that?
That's German. He doesn't understand English.
Gosh, a dog that knows German. He's some dog, isn't he?
Look, Danny, just out of the oven, your favorite. What's the matter with your hand?
Nothing.
Let me see. Why, honey, when'd you do this? How'd it happen? You're burning up with fever.
I'm all right.
Well, let Dr. Harrison decide that.
I don't need any old doctor.
We'll see.
Oh.
Up to bed now.
Bed? Gee whiz.
Do as mother tells you.
I won't.
I don't want to have to tell your dad about this.
You can't tell Dad anything. You haven't got the right telling my Dad anything about me.
Oh, you don't know what you're saying.
Do so. We don't want you here. I wish you'd never come. I wish you'd leave me and Dad alone. That's what I wish.
So he kept it a secret for 3 days. Huh. Wonder why.
He's afraid to tell us, I guess.
That's not like Danny. I always taught him to face things, and he always has.
Dr. Harrison examined that dog, I suppose.
Yes. Doc says the animal's as healthy as can be. Just mean and vicious.
Well, that's a relief. I was afraid that...
Danny's infection came from neglect. That bite would have healed normally if he'd taken care of it at once. He did seem upset. I suppose having a doctor frightened him a bit.
No, it wasn't that.
And you're keeping something from me.
I'm not keeping anything from you. Can't you see for yourself?
See? What?
The way Danny feels about me. That he resents my presence here to the point of hating me.
Oh, you're imagining things. Danny couldn't hate anybody.
I'm not imagining anything. I know how he feels about me because he told me. He hates me.
Oh, you're exaggerating.
He said he wished I'd get out of here.
He said that? Why, the little demon. I'll teach him. He can't talk to you like that.
You come back here. We can't solve this problem by losing our tempers.
If he can't talk to you that way, I won't stand for it.
You sit down. We've got to try and see his side of it.
But you've always been so good to him. I can't understand it.
Well, he resents my taking his mother's place.
Why didn't you tell me about this sooner?
I felt that it was my problem.
It's my problem as much as it is yours, dear. After all, I got you into this. Suppose I spoiled the boy trying to compensate him for the loss of his mother. I guess I overdid it. I know what I'll do. I'll send him away to military school. He needs discipline.
That's no good, Hugh, sending Danny away. Think how much you'd miss each other.
Yes, I know, but it's what he needs.
That's all we need to drive us apart.
How do you figure that?
Well, if he resents me now, think how he'd feel if you sent him away.
But he's got to learn.
And it wouldn't be long before you'd be resenting me for coming between you.
I can never feel any resentment for you, dear. After all...
That's a chance I wouldn't want to take. I love you too much. No, Hugh, we can't solve this problem by running away from it. If we do, our marriage will go on the rocks.
Well, what do you think we ought to do?
There must be some solution. And I intend to find it.
Rusty. Here, Rusty. Rusty, here.
What do you suppose ails him, Will?
Just plain ornery stubbornness. He wants to get out of here, and this is his way of trying to work it.
He'll starve himself to death.
Just let him get hungry enough.
Your dog and go around to the left. Henry, you take your dog and scout to the right. I'll take the center, and we'll all meet down at the creek, okay?
First one will see the rabbit yell. Come on, Trap.
Come on, Shorty.
Oh, Rusty. All right, you can have it. Gosh, what a big fella you are. Oh, you're hurt. Let me see. Gosh, you must have cut it on some glass. Say, tell me, how come you're way out here, Rusty? Gosh, you've run away. Well, come on, Rusty. I want to help you. You'll be all right. Come on, Rusty. Come, Stu. Come still here. Rusty, come still here.
Come still here. Come still here. Wash, honey. Dinner's almost ready.
What are we gonna have?
Aren't we having a rabbit?
Huh?
Didn't you get any?
Me?
You went rabbit hunting with the boys, didn't you?
Oh, yeah. Well, you see,
You should have seen the one that got away, is that it?
Yeah, you should have seen the one that got away.
Well, then you won't mind Chops.
Oh, no, he'll love him.
Who?
Danny.
He always does, you know that. Now, don't go away, Danny. Dinner's almost ready, and you know how your dad hates to be kept waiting.
I'll be right back. I forgot something. I gotta go now, Rusty. You'll be safe here. I'll see you later. Goodness. Gosh. He sure is tough. But I can manage you. bed.
Yes?
What happened to that book?
Which book?
The dictionary.
It's over there on that end table, I think.
Not Webster's, the other one.
Which one?
The German one.
You mean that old college book of mine?
Uh-huh.
Well, it must be around somewhere. Maybe I could help you, son. What do you want to know?
I want to look up for something.
Well, what?
Well, how would a fellow say, come with me, for instance?
Come with me? Well, komm mit mir. I think that's right, if I haven't forgotten everything I learned at college.
Komm mit mir.
Why this sudden interest in speaking German?
Huh? Oh, on account of a fellow I know. A German.
Where'd you meet him?
At the Hill.
Well, doesn't he speak English?
No.
Was he a refugee?
Yeah. Yeah, he's a refugee.
Well, where does he live?
Oh, around here.
How old is he?
He's not very old.
About your age?
A little younger, I guess.
Tough on these poor refugee kids. Torn away from their homes and their families.
You must be very nice to him, Danny.
Yeah, I am.
You must need a friend badly. So far from home and in a strange country.
He sure does, the poor fellow.
You like him?
Yeah.
Good.
Dad.
Hmm?
How does a fellow say, here's some food?
Here's some what? Here's some food?
Uh-huh.
You mean in German?
Uh-huh.
Is he hungry?
Not right now, but he's likely to be. You know how it is.
Well, if he's hungry, Danny, you must bring him here.
I thought of that.
Hasn't he any family, any parents?
Oh, yes, he has.
Well, then where?
They stayed behind.
Refugee, you know, dear. Parents send the kid out and stay behind themselves.
Poor thing.
I'd like to meet him, Danny. Our local welfare board ought to know about his case. What's his religion?
He doesn't talk about it.
Hmm. Still scared. Can't get used to the idea of living in a free country yet. Bring him around, son.
How do you say it, then?
Here's some food? Well, Harris etwas essen. Hmm.
We've got some of that apple pie I baked today, Danny. You can take him a piece in the morning.
He doesn't like apple pie.
Well, how do you know?
He never eats pie.
It's about time he learned to enjoy one of our great American institutions.
But how do you know his likes and dislikes, Danny, if he doesn't speak English and you don't speak German?
Yes, that's right.
Well, I guess we just understand each other, I guess. And, how would a fellow say, stand up, sit down, stay here, come back here, be quiet, go get him.
Hold on there, son. He came thousands of miles to get away from dictatorship. You mustn't talk to him that way.
Why, he won't mind. He's the toughest old dog you've ever seen.
Dog?
I thought you were talking about a boy.
No, it's a dog. I thought I'd kind of break the news a little easy-like.
Where is this dog?
I put him in our cellar.
You put him in our cellar?
Well, Rusty's a fugitive, so I thought it best to hide him for a while.
Rusty? You mean that dog belonging to Will Nelson?
Uh-huh.
It's a German army dog, dear. Nelson got hold of him somehow when he received his medical discharge. He was telling me about him. Danny, you didn't steal that dog, did you?
No, I found him in the hills. He was hurt, so I brought him home.
He must have run away.
Hmm. Well, I'll tell Nelson in the morning that his dog's here.
Well, can I keep him?
Isn't that the dog that bit you?
He didn't mean it. It was all my fault. I pulled his tail. Dog's got a right to defend his dignity, don't he?
You can't keep an animal as vicious as that. It'd be dangerous.
He's not dangerous. He was just insulted. How would you feel if somebody pulled your
tail? Danny, that's enough.
I'd never have a moment's peace of mind with an animal like that around the house.
Oh, Dad, please, can't
I? Your mother's right, son. It's too dangerous. And besides, he's someone else's property.
Oh, I never thought of that.
Yes. Now, can I depend on you to see that he gets back to Mr. Nelson the first thing in the morning?
Yes.
It's your bedtime, son.
Okay.
Good night, Danny.
Good night.
Good night, son.
Dad.
Hmm?
Go get him. How do you say it in German?
Now, you listen to me, young man.
That dog goes back to Mr. Nelson the first thing in the morning. You hear me?
Yeah.
What's that?
That means yes in German.
Good night, son. What do you suppose is getting into that kid, anyway?
Do you remember how you felt at Danny's age about a dog you brought home and couldn't keep?
I never brought home any vicious animal. I used discretion.
You don't expect discretion at Danny's age. Only feelings.
That sounds like you're arguing Danny's case. Just a moment ago, you were set against it.
I know, but that was only out of concern for Danny's safety. Perhaps he did rile the dog by pulling his tail.
Look, dear, Nelson says that dog's an ugly customer. A kid like Danny couldn't control him.
Well, if it were left up to me, I'd say he could keep him.
Hello, Rusty. Come meet me. That sure is a funny way to say, let's take a walk. You gotta learn English, that's all. Come stew here. Come on. That's what it means. You understand? Come on. Come on. Kommst. Come on. Kommst du her? Come on. Yes, sir. I found him in the hills while I was looking for rabbits.
Yeah, he's a bad article.
I think he's just kind of rugged. It isn't very agreeable being shut up, especially if you're a dog, too.
What makes you say that?
Well, it's maybe because I kind of know how he felt.
Oh, I see. Just how did he feel?
I like dogs, and I had a soul dog once. His name was Skipper. He couldn't bear being shut up any place. It isn't right doing that to a dog. A dog needs a place to run around a lot. He needs someone who's interested in him, too. You don't like Rusty, and he knows it.
Yeah, it's because he's no good. And since it's hopeless to try to do anything with him, why...
You're not gonna...
He's too vicious. He ought to be put out of the way before he can hurt anybody.
Please, Mr. Nelson, it isn't Rusty's fault. Please give him another chance. Please?
Well, I don't know. See that?
He doesn't mean anything bad. He's just full of... intestinal fortitude.
That's a lot of something for anyone to be full of.
Yeah.
Rusty just needs a little time to learn, that's all. And if you got no time to teach him, well...
You mean you'd like the job?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, he's sure a mean, unfriendly rascal.
Well, that's just because he never had a real friend.
What do you say, Florence?
If it's all right with these parents, it's all right with me.
What's your home telephone number, Danny?
Valley 0194.
Hello. May I speak to Mr. Mitchell, please? Oh, this is Miss Mitchell? Well, this is Will Nelson over at Fisherman's Creek. Your son, Danny... No, nothing happened to him. He's all right. He just asked me for one of my dogs, and I thought perhaps I'd better ask your permission. What's that? Uh-huh. I see. Yes, I understand. Thanks.
What does she say?
Well, she sort of passed it on to your father.
Oh.
What's your father's business number, Danny?
City 1862.
Dinner, Danny.
Thanks.
Doesn't he like his new house?
I'm sure he likes it. He's just got to get used to it.
Oh.
Gratitude for you.
Well, thanks for the recipe. I'll let you know how it turns out.
This one never misses.
Well, hello, Danny. Don't you have a word for old friends?
Well...
Well, what's the matter with him? How are you two hitting it off?
Pretty good.
Just pretty good, Anne? I had a feeling there was something wrong.
I never dreamed Danny would act like this. I've always loved him as much as if he were my own.
Oh, yes, but you never know what gets into kids' minds.
If I'd had any idea before I married Hugh...
You would have married him just the same. Now, darling, don't let this get you down. Things will adjust themselves in time. Rome wasn't built in a day.
I've done everything to win him over. I even urged Hugh to let him have that German dog because his heart was so set on it. Mm-hmm. I even take care of the dog. But nothing I do seems to make any difference.
How's he getting on with the dog?
He can't get him to respond at all. It breaks his heart.
Oh. Look, darling, I've got to get back to the baby. Oh, by the way, Anne, Dr. Banning, the psychiatrist, is in town. He's staying at the Harry Taylors. They're old friends, you know.
Dr. Banning? He wrote a book, didn't he?
Yes, that's the one. He's going to give a lecture at the auditorium. We ought to go.
I'd love to.
Now, don't mention that I told you, but Susan Larrabee went to him with George. You know how peculiar that boy is. It seems he has a persecution complex. Well, anyway, Dr. Banning straightened that kid out 1, 2, 3, and Susan swears by him, says he's a miracle man.
That's very interesting.
Well, bye now, sweet. I'll give you a call.
Bye.
Yes?
Is Dr. Banning in?
He is.
We'd like to see him, please.
We?
Yes, sir.
What is the nature of your call?
You see, we got a serious problem.
Do you have an appointment?
No. Isn't a problem enough?
What's your name?
Danny Mitchell, and this is Rusty.
Wait here a moment. Excuse me, Doctor. You have a couple of visitors.
Well, who are they, Russell?
Danny Mitchell and a Rusty.
Well, show them in, please.
Very well, sir. Come in, please. Your visitor, sir.
That'll be all, Russell. Well, young man, you've come to see me?
Yes, sir, we have.
Oh, both of you. Well, Danny, I'm glad to know you.
Glad to know you, Doctor.
Say, he's not very sociable, is he?
He's got a complex.
So I see. Well, what can I do for you, son?
Well, it's not me, Doc. It's him.
Oh, sit down, won't you?
Of course, Doctor. I know you're not an animal doctor, but animals have got feelings just the same as people. So I thought you could straighten him out just like you do people.
Well, what seems to be your problem?
He's got a complex.
Yes, so you said. Well, just how does his complex manifest itself? I mean, suppose you tell me how he acts.
He's treacherous.
A dog treacherous? That's unusual.
He picks on littler dogs.
Anything else?
Well, he doesn't know how to play or have a good time, and he doesn't like people or other dogs.
Go on, Danny.
Well, he won't obey you unless you're mean to him. And no matter how good you treat him, he's still kind of mean-like.
Doesn't respond, eh?
And he don't ever laugh.
Be a little odd if he did, wouldn't it?
Oh, no, Doc. You see, I had a great little old dog once. His name was Skipper. He used to laugh, and we had the greatest times. You couldn't see him laughing, but you knew he was doing it all the time.
How long have you had Rusty?
Not very long.
Where'd you get him?
He was given to me by a discharged soldier. He's a German dog. I've had to teach him English.
Oh, I think I'm beginning to understand. Danny, you've got a real tough job on your hands.
I have.
Does Rusty feel that you're his friend? Well, here's what I suggest you do. Feed him well, give him shelter, and then ignore him. Let him know that he isn't important to anybody unless he earns that importance. And let him come to you, which he may do as soon as he realizes what he is missing. And every time that Rusty does something that you want him to do, give him a little reward, a piece of meat or something else that he may like. You see, it may be that in his early training, he was punished every time he didn't do something right. That could be the reason for his slyness and treachery. Once you've taught him to expect a reward instead of punishment, I think you're well on the way toward having the kind of a dog you want.
Do you think it'll cure his complex?
Well, let's see. And let me know how it goes.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Oh, never mind about the fee. I only charge when the patient is cured. That's an old Chinese custom.
Is it? Come on, Rusty. Come on! You see?
That's the lad, all right. He was here this morning with his own particular problem. A very likable boy.
I can't tell you how much I would appreciate any help you might be able to give me, Doctor.
I know, Mrs. Mitchell, and I'm very glad you came to see me because I'm interested in that boy. It's important for his own sake, as much as yours, that he be cured of these prejudices.
Well, what can I do? I've tried everything. Sometimes I feel that I'm spoiling him.
The boy must be conditioned into the right behavior pattern. These outbreaks of resentment must be ignored. And you must always reward him for anything he does that meets with your approval. One of the main reasons he resents your presence in the household is because of the competition you provide for his father's affection.
I give Danny competition?
Not knowingly or intentionally. But perhaps there are some things you do for Mr. Mitchell that the boy has been doing.
Oh. I think I understand.
In the future, let Danny come to you. Let him try to win your approval. And by always rewarding his right actions, he'll develop an awareness of the right behavior method.
I can't thank you enough, Doctor.
Oh, there's time enough for that. And let me know how you get along. I'm very much interested.
Yes, I will.
You'll be late to register, Danny. Summer school opens tomorrow, you know.
I overslept. Nobody wake me. Goodbye, Dad.
Bye, Sonny.
Goodbye.
Goodbye, Danny. More coffee, dear?
Please. Good coffee, dear.
I'm glad. Drop something, Danny.
What's that, son?
How do you like it?
Well, it's wonderful. I'd recognize Rusty anywhere. Splendid likeness, isn't it, Ann?
Mm-hmm. Bedtime, Danny. Put your things away before you go up.
Good night, son.
Night, Dad. Night.
Night.
Aren't you feeling well, dear?
I'm all right.
So far, everything worked out all right. Are you sure you know how to reach our destination?
Naturally. I was selected for this job because I was stationed here before the war started.
What on earth's the matter with Rusty, son? He's been hollering his head off for the last 15 minutes.
Probably wants his breakfast.
Didn't you give it to him?
He's your dog, Danny. Feeding him is your responsibility.
I get it, son. You pour out the milk, hmm? There you are. Anne?
Yes?
Has Danny been misbehaving lately? More than usual, I mean.
I wouldn't say that he has. Why?
Well, sometimes you seem so, I understand Danny can be pretty exasperating at times, and I really don't blame you for...
For what?
Well, for reacting to him the way you do. After all, he isn't your own.
If he were my own, I couldn't love him more.
You haven't always given that impression lately, dear. If you are trying to win his affection, you're going about it in a rather strange way.
I know. Hugh, I've been to see a psychiatrist.
You mean about Danny?
Yes. He said that I was giving Danny too much unearned attention. And he advised me to let him come to me.
Mm-hmm, maybe he's right. But on the other hand...
Well, I'm trying it out. I didn't get any place with Danny when I really gave him attention and affection.
Well, you do as you think best. But don't you start using that technique on me.
So far, that hasn't been necessary.
And it won't be, sweetheart.
Hey, Danny! Danny! Hey, Danny! Coming!
No, you can't come along. You can't do anything until you learn to be a normal dog. So be quiet.
How did he make out?
Not so good. I got a few things.
Police dog.
Come here. Come here. Comes to her.
Don't be a fool. He doesn't understand German.
Comes to her.
He does understand me.
He must have German owners. Maybe we have friends around here.
Hello, boy.
Now that you've got him, what are you going to do with him?
The woods are full of rabbits. And the farmers around here have some fine fat chickens. He'll help us to kill him.
He's all right.
That's his nine plots. Leighton! Leighton!
Hello, son. Been out again all afternoon?
Dad, where could he be? I've been looking almost a week now. I've looked all over. Do you suppose he thought I didn't want him on account of the way I've been acting?
Well, if that's the reason you ran away, he's beginning to act like a normal dog.
What good is that? He's gone.
Listen to this, son. The mystery of numerous complaints which have been coming to the Hillside Police Precinct from small farm owners in the vicinity that poultry was being stolen from their hen coops is thought to be solved today. A large police dog, evidently abandoned, was seen by farmer Herman Lawson leaping over his fence with a chicken between his jaws. Police have enlisted the aid of volunteers to hunt down and destroy the marauder.
Rusty!
Could be. Wait a minute, son. There's nothing more you can do.
Well, they'll kill him. He's only hungry. He doesn't mean anything bad.
Tomorrow's Saturday. You'll be able to start out early in the morning.
Aren't you two ever coming in to eat? What's the matter, Danny? Rusty? Do you think he's the
one?
In
all probability.
Dad, I've got to find him.
He'll come back, honey.
He won't come back, and you don't want me to find him.
Of course I want you to find him.
You just say that. You never wanted me to have him.
Hush, Danny, you know that isn't so.
Supper's on the table.
Come on in, son.
I don't want any.
Dad, I'm gonna look for Rusty. I've got to.
At this time of day?
You can't stop me.
There's still a couple of hours of daylight left, dear. Go ahead, son. But get back before dark.
Really, Hugh. The very idea, letting him go out at this time of day, without a supper.
He doesn't want to eat. You can't force him to. Sometimes other things are more important than food.
Yes, I know. And peace of mind is one of them.
Exactly. And yet you expect him to sit down and eat his supper when his most prized possession's in danger. Really, Anne, you surprise me sometimes at your complete lack of understanding.
I've tried very hard to understand. You know that. As a last resort, I went to a psychiatrist. But scientific methods don't seem to be the answer. Perhaps it was your mistake. Maybe you chose the wrong mother for Danny.
Maybe if there was more of us looking, we could find him.
Yeah. We could try to get some of the other kids to help us. We could start early in the morning.
Gee, that'd be swell.
I'll call Bob and Larry as soon as I get home. Maybe they can get some more.
I can get a bunch together. Where'll we meet?
Well, how about Will Nelson's place?
Swell. Let's make it early. 8 o'clock, say.
That's it. 8 o'clock, Nelson's place.
Okay. So
well. We'll break up into squads. Henry, you take Bud and Harry down by Lawson's farm. Billy, you take Larry, Jack, and Herman off near the creek. And I'll take the other end of the woods with Bob and Dick.
Herbie, what are you doing here?
I'm going hunting for Rusty.
Oh, no, you're not. You're going home to Mom. Go on.
Now, does everybody understand what he's to do?
Yeah.
You all got some rope?
Yeah, I got a rope.
Go on home, pest.
All right, kids, let's start.
Come on, fellas. We're going.
Serve you right.
That's my business.
I'll leave the kid alone. He's got guts.
Come on.
If he's hungry, if he wants to eat, he better be faster than the rabbits. Come with me. Come. Come. Be back soon.
Good luck.
I bet it was you who's been stealing those farmers' chickens and sending Rusty to do it.
You're quite a smart boy.
You give me my dog.
You won't have much use for him.
Danny! Those are my friends. They'll tell you whose dog Rusty is.
You get away from him! Rusty! Go get him!
Rusty! Come on! Get
The guys we've been looking for, all right?
Yeah, you're right. Thanks, fellas. You've rendered a great service to your country. You're real heroes.
He's the one that deserves most of the credit.
Yeah, he's got guts. He's my little brother.
Oh, it was nothing, fellas.
Dad! We found Rusty!
For man, she's left.
Left? I bet they're biting slow today. Look at all the bait I got, Dad. Enough to catch all the fish in the creek.
What did you say, son?
Oh, nothing. Just thought you might feel like going fishing.
How do you like the color combination now?
Nice.
Oh, and you didn't even look.
My gosh, Louise. Every time you add a new row, you ask me what I think of it. I told you before I thought it was stunning.
All right. I won't ask you again.
I didn't mean to bite your head off. I'm sorry.
Oh, I'll go. Oh, why, Danny, what a pleasant surprise.
Hello, Louise.
Well, come on in, Danny. How are you?
Louise, my mother. Is she here?
Inside.
Anne.
Yes, Danny.
I hope you don't mind my coming here like this.
Of course not. But how'd you know where I'd be?
Well, I kind of figured. Louise being your very best friend, next to Dad and me. Well, sort of different home now.
Hugh, your father, he's all right?
Sort of.
How do you mean?
Well, he just don't seem very interested in anything anymore. He won't even come fishing.
He won't?
He just sits and smokes on his pipe. And he doesn't put any tobacco in it. And he doesn't light it, even when there is some. I sort of figured why he acts that way.
You have?
I kind of think that maybe if someone else brought them to him, he'd, well, not be so forgetful-like.
But you wouldn't want anybody else bringing them to him, would you, Danny?
That's woman's work, anyway. Bring old pipe and tobacco to a man, that's nothing for a fellow to be doing. It isn't, well, it isn't masculine, being a servant-like. That's what it isn't.
And you'd like to see me bringing them to him, Danny?
I didn't mean anything I said. I didn't mean one word. Cross my heart and hope to die. I'll always keep my face clean, and I'll never act bad at mealtimes anymore. And I'll always wipe my shoes if they're muddy. And I'll always wash behind my ears. And I won't go barefoot, and I don't care about Dad's old pipe and things, because I want you to take care of them all the time. Because I'm going to be awful busy looking after Rusty. And please come home. Please, Mom. Dad wants you to. We both want you to. Please.
And now, kids, there's some real good fishing. Bye, Mom. So long, Dad. Come on, Rusty.
Hey, wait a minute.
What?
We're going with you.
Yeah, gee. Well, come on.
Come on
there, fella.
In you get, boys.
In you go,
Rusty.